The Tibetan Mastiff is a medium to large-sized Tibetan dog breed. Its double coat is medium to long, subject to climate, and found in a wide variety of colors, including solid black, black and tan, various shades of red, from pale gold to deep red, and bluish gray, dilute black, often with white and blue markings. Name: the name Tibetan Mastiff is a misnomer, as the breed is not a true Mastiff. The term Mastiff was assigned by the Europeans who first came to Tibet, because that name was used to refer to nearly all large dog breeds in the West. Early Western visitors to Tibet misnamed several of its breeds, such as the Tibetan Terrier, which is not a terrier, and the Tibetan Spaniel, which is not a spaniel. A better name for the breed might be the Tibetan Mountain Dog, or, to encompass the landrace breed throughout its range, the Himalayan Mountain Dog. Appearance: some breeders differentiate between two types of Tibetan Mastiff, the Dukhi, GS is not pronounced in Lhasa Tibetan, and the Tsangkhi. The Tsangkhi, which, to a Tibetan, means only dog from Tsang, is also referred to as the monastery type, described as generally taller, heavier, and more heavily boned, with more facial wrinkling and haw than the Dukhi type. Both types are often produced in the same litter, with the larger, heavier pups being placed in more stationary jobs versus more active jobs for the Tibetan Mastiffs that are better structured and well-muscled. The Tibetan Mastiff is considered a primitive breed. It typically retains the hardiness which would be required for it to survive in Tibet and the high-altitude Himalayan range, including the northern part of Nepal, India, and Bhutan. Instinctive behaviors, including canine pack behavior, contributed to the survival of the breed in harsh environments. It is one of the few primitive dog breeds that retains a single estrus per year instead of two, even at much lower altitudes and in much more temperate climates than its native climate. This characteristic is also found in wild canids such as the wolf and other wild animals. Since its estrus usually takes place during late fall, most Tibetan Mastiff puppies are born between December and January. Its double coat is long, subject to climate, and found in a wide variety of colors, including solid black, black and tan, various shades of red, from pale gold to deep red, and bluish gray, dilute black, often with white markings. Some breeders are now, as of 2014, marketing white Tibetan Mastiffs. These dogs are actually very pale gold, not truly white. Photoshop is often used to make dogs of normal colors appear white in advertisements. The coat of a Tibetan Mastiff lacks the unpleasant big dog smell that affects many large breeds. The coat, whatever its length or colors, should shed dirt and odors. Although the dogs shed somewhat throughout the year, there is generally one great molt in late winter or early spring, and sometimes another, lesser molt in the late summer or early fall. Sterilization of the dog may dramatically affect the coat as to texture, density and shedding pattern. Tibetan Mastiffs are shown under one standard in the West, but separated by the Indian breed standard into two varieties: lion head, smaller, exceptionally long hair from forehead to withers, creating a rougher mane, and tiger head, larger, shorter hair. Temperament: as a flock guardian dog in Tibet and in the West, it uses all the usual livestock guardian tactics, e.g., barking, scent marking perimeters, to warn away predators and avoid direct confrontations. As a socialized, more domestic dog, it can thrive in a spacious fenced yard with a canine companion, but it is generally not an appropriate dog for apartment living. The Western bred dogs are generally more easygoing, although still somewhat aloof with strangers coming to the home. Through hundreds of years of selective breeding for a protective flock and family guardian, the breed has been prized for being a nocturnal sentry, keeping would-be predators and intruders at bay, barking at sounds throughout the night. Leaving a Tibetan Mastiff outside all night with neighbors nearby is not recommended. They often sleep during the day, making them more active, alert and aware at night. Like all flock guardian breeds, they are intelligent and stubborn to a fault, so obedience training is recommended, although it is only mildly successful with some individuals, since this is a strong-willed, powerful-bodied breed. Unless they are to be used exclusively as livestock guardians, socialization training is also critical with this breed, because of their reserved nature with strangers and guardian instincts. They can be excellent family dogs depending on the family. Owners must understand canine psychology and be able and willing to assume the primary leadership position. Lack of consistent rational discipline can result in the creation of dangerous, unpredictable dogs. The protectiveness of Tibetan Mastiffs requires alertness and planning by the owner in order to avoid mishaps when the dog is merely reacting as a guardian. The breed is not recommended for novice dog owners. The Tibetan Mastiff originated as a herding and guarding dog for the nomads of Tibet, and as a watchdog in Tibetan monasteries. The Tibetan Mastiff is a phenotypically distinct dog breed that was bred as a flock guardian in the high altitudes of the Himalayas and the Tibetan plateaus. 78 Mir Izadulla, 1872, wrote the dogs of Tibet are twice the size of those seen in India, with large heads and hairy bodies. They are powerful animals. During the day they are kept chained up and are let loose at night to guard their master's house. In the early 20th century the Prince of Wales, George, introduced a pair of Tibetan Mastiffs, and enough of the breed were available in England in 1906 to be shown at the Crystal Palace show. However, during the war years, the breed lost favor and focus and nearly died out in England. The breed has been gaining in popularity worldwide since 1980. Although the breed is still considered somewhat uncommon, as more active breeders arose and produced adequate numbers of dogs, various registries and show organizations, FCI, AKC, began to recognize the breed. In 2008, the Tibetan Mastiff competed for the first time in the Westminster Kennel Club Dog Show. Since AKC recognition, the number of active breeders has skyrocketed, leading to overbreeding of puppies, many of which are highly inbred and of questionable quality. Initially, the breed suffered because of the limited gene pool from the original stock. By 2015, due to excessive breeding and unsuitability of the breed as a pet in urban situations, prices in China for the best dogs had fallen to about $2,000, and both lower quality and crossbreed dogs were being abandoned. In 2011, a DNA study concluded that there was a genetic relationship between the Tibetan Mastiff and the Great Pyrenees, Bernese Mountain Dog, Rottweiler, and Saint Bernard, and that these large breed dogs are probably partially descended from the Tibetan Mastiff. In 2014, a study added the Leonberger to the list of possible relatives.